בחינות הבגרות באנגלית, מועד חורף תשע"ד 2014, לתלמידים אינטרניים ואקסטרניים הנבחנים בשאלון ה' מודול E. שלום רב. היום אתם נבחנים בבחינות הבגרות בשפה האנגלית, ובעוד רגע ישודר הקטע בהבנת הנשמע. נשמיע לכם את הקטע הזה פעמיים. הודעה חשובה למשגיחי הבחינות ולנבחנים, אסור להקליט את הקטעים. יש להאזין לקטעים בשתי הקריאות שבשידור בלבד. בסיום השידור, על התלמידים לשים את מקלטי הרדיו או כל מכשיר אחר בצידי החדר.
Hello, students. Today you are sitting for your Bagrut examination in English. In a moment, you will hear the text of your listening comprehension test, which will be read twice. And now, the first broadcast.
ועתה השידור הראשון.
Hello, listeners. This is Rita Pearson welcoming you to our program, Living Well. With us in the studio today is Dr. Robert Hartley, a specialist eye doctor at Midtown Hospital. Hello, Dr. Hartley.
Good afternoon, Rita.
Dr. Hartley, you were invited here to talk about a problem many people have, which is known as myopia. First of all, could you explain to us what myopia is?
It's very simple, really. People who have myopia have trouble seeing objects that are far away. The only way they can see them clearly is by wearing glasses or contact lenses. Myopia is a very common condition, which affects about 25% of the world population. And now it's becoming even more common, especially among children. The increase has been seen in reports from eye doctors all over the world, and also in the results of the eye tests given in many schools. This data has attracted the attention of researchers.
And what have they discovered?
Well, interestingly enough, the increase is found only in children living in cities. Outside the cities, there has been no significant change in the number of children with myopia. The reason for this may be that today, city children spend most of their time indoors. Even when they meet with friends, they usually stay in the house or go to a shopping mall. Outside the cities, kids generally spend more time outdoors.
And have studies shown that spending time outdoors does, in fact, make a difference?
Yes, they have. Researchers have found that children who are outdoors a lot have a lower chance of developing myopia. Let me give you an example. A year-long study done in China examined kids in two elementary schools in the same town. In one school, the kids were told to stay inside during the breaks between lessons. In the second school, the children had to go outside during the break. At the end of the year, both groups had their eyesight checked. It turned out that 10% more of the kids who stayed inside developed myopia as compared to those who went outside. Clearly, staying inside increased the chances of getting myopia.
Can doctors explain why being outdoors makes children less likely to get myopia?
Well, one reason may be the effect of sunlight. Research has shown that bright light is needed for children's eyes to develop properly, and sunlight is brighter than the artificial light indoors. Secondly, when children are indoors, they spend much of their time looking at things that are close to them. For example, a book or a computer screen. When objects are close, your eyes have to work hard to focus on them. But when you are outside, your eyes have time to rest because you're mostly looking at things that are farther away.
So, you're saying we should encourage our kids to spend more time outdoors?
Yes, definitely. If we can get that message across to parents and schools, I believe fewer children will develop this problem with their eyesight.
I certainly hope parents and
research has shown that bright light is needed for children's eyes to develop properly, and sunlight is brighter than the artificial light indoors. Secondly, when children are indoors, they spend much of their time looking at things that are close to them. For example, a book or a computer screen. When objects are close, your eyes have to work hard to focus on them. But when you are outside, your eyes have time to rest because you're mostly looking at things that are farther away.
So, you're saying we should encourage our kids to spend more time outdoors?
Yes, definitely. If we can get that message across to parents and schools, I believe fewer children will develop this problem with their eyesight.
I certainly hope parents and educators take your advice. This ends our program. Thank you very much, Dr. Hartley, and to you listeners, goodbye.
זה היה השידור השני. אם לא סיימתם להשיב על השאלות, המשיכו לעשות זאת עכשיו, ואחר כך המשיכו בשאר חלקי הבחינה. משרד החינוך וכל ישראל מאחלים לכולכם הצלחה בבחינות הבגרות.